Hello and welcome to my channel Malavika's Magic. Today I bring for you another board game which I have named it as Game of Homophones. Now I am sure you must be knowing what is the meaning of homophones. That is words which sound similar but have different meaning and they are also spelled differently. And now you as a teacher, you can incorporate any aspects that you feel that the learner should understand or should have a better understanding. And thus, you know, like you can name it also in a different way. So I have included homophones because I felt that it is important for the learners to understand the different words, you know, or the vocabulary or to improve their vocabulary. So this game can be played in an offline or in an online mode, but in both the situation, the teacher needs to have a control of the board so that the teacher can monitor the learning of the learners. And in an offline mode, of course, the groups, you know, the different groups can be made so that all the learners are involved, and moreover, there is an atmosphere of competition that actually motivates the learners, you know, to go ahead with the game. In an online mode also, the competition can be included. Students can be divided into different groups, but in an online mode, the teacher has to ask the groups, you know, to turn on the video so that the dice can be rolled, and accordingly, the other groups can see, you know, what number is reflected on the dice. And thus, you know, the game can be played with all the students involved in the process. So here also I will demonstrate how this game can be played. So first I click here, then you can see the dice, and then again we click. So it's number 3, and the learner has to take another turn. So it's number 4. So it's written over here, move 4 spaces backwards. So therefore, you know, the learner goes back to the previous place, and then again the learner clicks. So it is number 3. And here the group, you know, who is supposed to give this answer gives the answer, but the other groups are involved in a way that they have to evaluate the answer and also come up with their opinion. And thus, you know, it not only involves the other students, you know, to be a part of the learning process, but also it makes the class interactive. And at the same time, the discussion follows, and this discussion helps all the learners to acquire more information about the concept of homophones. And this way the game can move ahead. And so here again, in this particular word also, the group that is assigned, you know, the responsibility of giving an answer, that group can, you know, give the answer, but the other groups will be involved in terms of evaluating the answer and coming up with their own views and opinion or their own ideas about the particular word. And thus, you know, this game can be played ahead. So this way, the learner wins the game. Once the learner wins the game, then of course there could be an applause in an offline class. Of course, the applause could come from the other group, other members. And in an online class, you can include the sound of applause over here, or otherwise even the students can be involved in applauding. So here, I hope you have actually, you know, learned how to introduce games in the class, and how you've also understood that the concept of games is not distracting. In fact, the concept of games, you know, allows the learner to learn in an informal atmosphere, and this informal atmosphere actually motivates them to remain focused in the process of learning. And I'm sure you'll be implementing this game in the class. If you have any suggestion about how differently we can implement this game, you can please write it in the comment section so that even I get an idea and I can also implement in a different way. Thank you once again for your patient listening. And if you have any suggestions regarding this game, could you please put it in the comment section? Thank you once again.